just one of them rambling boys, rambling round and making noise. Sometimes lonely, sometimes blue, no one knows it better than you. Rambling round, rambling pearl, rambling down through the world. Rambling down, rambling pearl, rambling down through the world.
Thank you very much. While riding on a train gone west, I fell asleep for to take my rest. I dreamed a dream that made me sad concerning myself and the first few friends I had. With half damp eyes, I stared to the room where my friends and I spent many an afternoon. Well, we together weathered many a storm, laughing and joking till the early hours of the morn. By the old wooden stove where our hats was hung, our words were told, our songs was sung. Well, we longed for nothing and were quite satisfied, laughing and joking about the wicked world outside. With hungry hearts through the heat and cold, we never much thought we could get very old. We thought we could sit forever in fun when our chances really was a million to one. As easy it was to tell black from white, it was all that easy to tell wrong from right. And our choices was few, and the thought never hit
like the one road we traveled would ever shatter or split. Ah, many a year has passed and gone, and many a gamble has been lost and won. And many a road taken by many a friend, and each one I've never seen again. I wish in vain that we could sit simply in that room again. $10,000 at the drop of a hat, I'd give it all gladly if our lives could be like that. Rambling out of the wild west, leaving the towns I love the best. I thought I'd seen some ups and downs till I rambled into New York town. Buildings going down on the ground, people going up to the sky. Wintertime in New York town, wind blows the snow around. You can walk around, there's nowhere to go. Fella could freeze right to the bone, froze right to the bone. New York Times said it was the coldest winter in 17 years. I didn't feel so cold then. Well, I swung onto my old guitar and I grabbed hold of a subway car from a rockin', reelin', rollin' ride. I landed up on the downtown side, Greenwich Village, Folklore Center, Dizzy Young. Well, I walked down there and I ended up in one of them coffee houses on the block. But I'd get on the stage, sing and play, mind there, second back some other day, sound like a hillbilly. We're looking for folk singers around here. Got a harmonica job, begun to play, blowing my brains out for a dollar a day. I played inside out and upside down. Man there said he's crazy about my sound. He loved it. He's raving about it. Dollar a day's worth. Well, after weeks and weeks of hanging around, I finally got a job in New York town, in a bigger place, bigger money too. I even joined the union and paid my dues 6 months in advance. Now, a very great man, he once said that some people rob you with a fountain pen. In New York, it don't take too long to find out just what he was talking about. Lots of people don't have too much food on their tables. Well, they got a lot of forks, a lot of knives, and they gotta cut something. Watch out. So one morning when the sun was warm, I rambled out of New York town. I pulled my cap down over my eyes and I headed out for the western skies. So long, New York. Howdy, East Orange.
shot in the corner of it. This is called Hollis Brown. It's a true story. Hollis Brown, he lived on the outside of town. Hollis Brown, he lived on the outside of town. With his wife and five children and his cabin broken down. He looked for work and money and he walked the ragged mile. He looked for work and money and he walked the ragged mile. Your children are so hungry that they don't know how to smile. Your baby's eyes look crazy, they're tugging at your sleeve. Your baby's eyes look crazy, they're tugging at your sleeve. You walk the floor and wonder why with every breath you breathe. The rats had got your flower, bad blood had got your mare. The rats had got your flower, bad blood had got your mare. If there's anyone that knows, is there anyone that cares? He prayed to the Lord above, oh Pete, send you a friend. He prayed to the Lord above, oh please send you a friend. You ain't got no money, boy, you ain't got no friend. Your baby's crying louder now, it's a pounding on your brain. Your baby's crying louder now, it's a pounding on your brain. Your wife screams, just stabbing you like the dirty driving rain. Your grass is turning black, there's no water in your well. Your grass is turning black, there's no water in your well. You spent your last long dollar on seven shotgun shells. Way out in the wilderness, a cold coyote calls. Way out in the wilderness, a cold coyote calls. Your eyes fix on a shotgun that's hanging on the wall. Your brain is bleeding and your legs can't seem to stand. Your brain is a-bleeding and your legs can't seem to stand. Your eyes fix on a shotgun that you're holding in your hand. There's seven breezes blowing all around the cabin door. There's seven breezes blowing all around the cabin door. Seven shots sing out like the ocean's pound and roar. There's seven people dead on a South Dakota farm.
There's seven people dead on a South Dakota farm. Somewhere in the distance, there's seven new people born. Red Wing, it's a reform school. Don't have no high school football teams or nothing like that, though. Or no cheerleaders. Bad harmonica, too. Oh, the age of the inmates I remember quite freely. No younger than 12, no older than 17. Thrown in like bandits and cast off like criminals. Inside the grounds of the walls of Red Wing, from the dirty old mess hall you march to the brick wall, too weary to talk and too tired to sing. Oh, it's all afternoon, you remember your hometown. Inside the grounds, from the walls of Red Wing. Oh, the gates of cast iron and the walls of barbed wire. Stay far from the fence with electricity sting. They need to keep down your head and stay in your number. On the inside grounds of the walls of Red Wing. Oh, it's fare well to the deep hollow dungeon. Farewell to the boardwalk that takes you to the screen. And farewell to the minutes they threaten you with it. Inside the grounds of the walls of Red Wing. It's many a guard that stands around smiling, holding his club like he was a king. hoping to get you behind the wood piling. Inside the grounds of the walls of Red Wing, as the night in shadows through the crossbar windows, and the wind punched hard to make the wall siding sing. It's many a night I pretended to be asleeping on the inside grounds of the walls of Red Wing. As the rain rattled heavy on the bunkhouse shingles, and the sounds in the night, they made my ears ring. Yeah, the keys of the gods click the tune of the morning on the inside grounds of the walls of Red Wing. Well, some of us will wind up in St. Cloud Prison, and some of us will wind up to be lawyers and things. Some of us will wind up and you'll meet on your crossroads from inside the grounds of the walls of Red Wing.
Here's a 1930 ragtime tune I just wrote last week. Well, if I had to do it all over again, babe, I'd do it all over you. If I had to wait for 10,000 years, babe, I'd even do that too. Well, a dog's got his bone in the alley, a cat, she's got 9 lives. King, a millionaire's got $1 million, and King Saudi's got 400 wives. Well, everybody's got something that they're looking forward to. I'm looking forward to when I can do it all again. Babe, I'll do it all over you. Well, if I had my way, tomorrow or today, babe, I'd run circles all around. I'd jump up in the wind, do a somersault and spin. I'd even dance a jig on the ground. Well, everybody gets their hour, everybody gets their time. Little David, when he picked up his pebbles, even Samson after he went blind. Well, everybody gets their chance to do what they want to do. When my time arrives, you better run for your life. Oh, babe, I'll do it all over you. Well, I don't need no money, I just need a day that's sunny. Mama and my days are gonna come. I'll grab me a pint, you'll think that I'm a giant when you hear me yelling fee-fi-fo-fum.
Yeah, cut me like a jigsaw puzzle. You made me look like a walking wreck. When you pushed my heart through my backbone and you knocked off my head from my neck. Well, if I'm ever put back together, I'll be about to tell you what I'm gonna do. I tell you, little lover, that you better run for cover. Oh, babe, I'll do it all over you. Look out your window fire, you'll see me squatting there. Mama, I'm just resting on my shelf. I'll be all by myself, I don't need nobody else. When I come, what I'll do myself? Well, after my cigarettes have been smoked up, after all my liquor's been drunk, after all my dreams I've been dreamed out, after all my thoughts have been thunk, well, after I do some of these things, I'm gonna do what I have to do. And I tell you on the side that you better run and hide. Oh, babe, I'll do it all over you.
That's sort of a mad song. That's this one here. I never use a list. I don't much believe in lists, but I know most of the guitar players do have them now. I wanted to get the best songs on my list, you see. I didn't want to have none of these songs.
It's a
heartbreak! Oh, wow. Let me explain about my list first. I'll tell you about my list and I swear I'll get there. Anyway, I went around and I copied down all the best songs I could find off everybody else's list. That's why I'm in trouble, because some of these songs I don't know too well. Hard Rain ain't on my list. I was feeling sad and kind of blue. I didn't know what I was gonna do. The communists was coming around. They was in the air, they was on the ground. They wouldn't give me no peace. Well, I run down most hurriedly and joined the John Birch Society. Got me a secret membership card, started walking off down the road. You! I'm a real John Bircher now, look out. Now we all agree with Hitler's views, although he killed 6 million Jews. It don't matter too much that he was a fascist, at least you can't say he was a communist. That's to say, like, if you got a cold, take a shot of malaria. I was looking everywhere for them gold darn reds. I got up in the morning, looked under my bed. Looked in the sink behind the chair. Looked in the glove compartment of my car. Looking everywhere, I couldn't find them. I was looking in the sink and behind the chair. I was looking for them ribs everywhere. I looked way up a chimney hole, looked deep down inside my toilet bowl. I got away. I was sitting home alone and started to sweat. I figured they was in my TV set. I peeked behind the picture frame, got a shock from my feet, hit me in the brain. Them Reds did it. I know they did, them hardcore ones. I quit my job so I could work all alone, and I changed my name to Sherlock Holmes. Following some clues from my detective bag, I discovered there was red stripes in the American flag. Oh, Betsy Ross. Now, Eisenhower, he's a Russian spy. Lincoln, Jefferson, and that Roosevelt guy. To my knowledge, there's just one man that's really a true American. George Lincoln Rockwell. I know for a fact he hates commies because he picketed the movie Exodus. Well, I finally started thinking straight when I run out of things to investigate. Couldn't imagine doing anything else, and now I'm home investigating myself. Hope I don't find out anything. Good God. This is, I used to be quite romantic, and this song's called Boots of Spanish Leather, and something I can bring you from across the sea, from the place that I'll be landing. No, there's nothing you can bring me, my own true love. There's nothing I'm wishing to be owning. Just carry yourself back to me unspoiled, from across that lonesome ocean. Oh, but I just thought you might want something fine, made of silver or of golden, either from the mountains of Madrid or from the coast of Barcelona. Oh, but if I had the stars of the darkest night and the diamonds of the deepest ocean, I'd forsake them all for your sweet kiss, for it's all I'm wishing to be owning. Oh, but I might be gone a long old time, and it's only that I'm asking, is there something I can send you to remember me by, to make your time more easy passing? How can you ask me again? It only brings me sorrow, the same thing I would want today, I would want again tomorrow. Oh, I got a letter on a lonesome day. It was from her ship a-sailing, saying I don't know when I'll be coming back again. It depends on how I'm feeling. Well, if you, my love, must think that away, I'm sure your mind is roaming. I'm sure your thoughts are not with me, but with the country to where you're going. So take heed of the western wind. Take heed of the stormy weather. And yes, there's something you can send back to me. Send me boots of Spanish leather. For all the boys that know girls that want them to go out and get themselves killed. Well, the gal I love, I swear she's a screamer, yes, the gal I got, I swear she's a screaming in. She wants me to be a hero so she can tell all her friends. Well, she begged, she prayed, she pleaded with me all last night. Well, she begged, she prayed, she pleaded with me all this night. She wants me to go out and find somebody to fight. She reads too many books, she got new movies inside her head. She reads too many books, she got movies inside her head. She wants me to walk out running, she wants me to crawl back dead. You need a different kind of man, babe, one that can hold your heart. Yes. You need a different kind of man, babe, one that can hold your heart. You need a different kind of man, babe. You need Napoleon Bonaparte. Well, when I'm dead, no more good times will I crave. Oh, when I'm dead, no more good times will I crave. You can't stand and shout hero all over my lonesome grave. Here's a song that I wrote that's been recorded. It doesn't much sound like it, like the way I do it, but. But the words are the same. That's the important thing. Must a man walk down before you call him a man? How many seas must the white dove sail before she sleeps in the sand? Yes, and how many times must the cannonballs fly before they're forever banned? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. Yes, and how many years can a mountain exist before it is washed to the sea? Yes, and how many years can some people exist before they're allowed to be free? Yes, and how many times can a man turn his head and pretend that he just doesn't see? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. Yes, and how many times must a man look up before he can see the sky? Yes, and how many ears must one man have before he can hear a pea? people cry. Yes, and how many deaths will it take till he knows that too many people have died? The answer, my friend, is blowing in the wind. The answer is blowing in the wind. Here's another true story. Riding number 9 is true too, but you know.
Seems like number 9, boss.
Oh, seems like number 9. Put the light up there. Well, John. When John Brown went off to war to fight on a foreign shore, his mama sure was proud of him. He stood so straight and tall in his uniform and all. His mama's face broke out to a grin. Oh, son, you look so fine. I'm glad you're a son of mine. You make me proud to know you hold a gun. Do what the captain says, lots of medals you will get, and we'll put them on the wall when you come home. When that old train pulled out, John's mom begun to shout, telling everybody in the neighborhood, that's my son that's about to go. He's a stranger, he's a soldier now, you know. She made well sure her neighbors understood. She got a letter once in a while, her face broke into a smile as she showed them to the people from next door. And she bragged about her son with his uniform and gun in this thing she called a good old-fashioned war. Lord, good old fashioned war. And the letter ceased to come. For a long time they did not come. They ceased to come for about 9 months or more. When a letter finally came, saying, go down and meet the train. Your sons are coming home from the war. She smiled and went right down. She looked up and all around, but she did not see her soldier son in sight. But as all the people passed, she saw her son at last. When she did, she could hardly believe her eyes. Oh, his face was all shot up and his hand was all blown off as he wore a metal brace round his waist. He whispered kind of slow in a voice she did not know, while she could not even recognize his face. Lord, recognize his face. Tell me, my darling son, pray tell me what they've done. How is it that you come to be this way? As he tried his best to talk, but his mouth could hardly move, and his mother had to turn her face away. Don't you remember, Ma, when I went off to war? You thought it was the best thing I could do. I was on the battleground, you were home acting proud. Thank God you wasn't standing in my shoes. 'Cause I thought when I was there, God, what am I doing here? I'm trying to kill somebody or die trying. But the thing that scared me most is when my enemy came so close, and I saw that his face looked just like mine. Lord, Lord, just like mine. And I could not help but think, through the thunder sound instinct, that I was just a puppet in a play. And through the roaring smoke, the string had finally broke, and a cannonball blew my eyes away. As he turned away to walk, his ma was still in shock, seeing the metal brace that helped him stand. But as he turned to go, he called his mother close, and he dropped his medals down into her hand. Lord, Lord, down to her hand. This is this one called Tomorrow's a Long Time. If today was not a crooked highway, if tonight was not a crooked trail, if tomorrow wasn't such a long time, then lonesome would mean nothing to you at all. Isn't only if my own true love was waiting, if I could hear her heart is softly pounding. Isn't only if she was lying by me, and I'd lie in my bed once again. I can't see my reflection in the water. I can't speak the sounds to show no pain. I can't hear the echo of my footsteps or remember the sounds of my own name. Isn't only if my own true love was waiting, and if I could only hear her heart softly pounding. Isn't only if she was lying by me, that I'd lie in my bed once again. There's beauty in that silver singing river. There's beauty in that rainbow in the sky. But none of these and nothing else can touch the beauty that I remember in my true love's eyes. Yes, and only if my own true love was waiting, if I could only hear a heart is softly pounding. Yes, and only if she was lying by me, and I'd lie in my bed once again. Okay, here's a... I'll sing this last one here and end you have some sort of break or something. Darling young one, I've stumbled on the side of 12 misty mountains. I've walked and I've crawled on 6 crooked highways. I've stepped in the middle of 7 sad forests. I've been out in front of a dozen dead oceans. I've been 10,000 miles in the mouth of a graveyard. And it's hard, it's hard, it's hard, it's hard, it's hard. Rains are gonna fall. Oh, what did you see, my blue-eyed son? And what did you see, my darling young one? I saw a newborn baby with wild wolves all around it. Saw a highway of diamonds with nobody on it. I saw a black branch with blood that kept dripping. I saw a room full of men with hammers of bleeding. I saw 10,000 talkers whose tongues were all broken. I saw guns and sharp swords in the hands of young children. And it's hard, it's hard, it's hard, it's hard, it's hard. Rains are gonna fall. Oh, what did you hear, my blue-eyed son? And what did you hear, my darling young one? I heard the sound of a thunder that roared out a warning. I heard the roar of a wave that could drown the whole world. I heard 100 drummers whose hands was a-blazing. I heard 10,000 whispering and nobody listening. I heard one person starve, I heard many people laughing. I heard the song of a poet who died in the gutter. I heard the sounds of a clown who cried in the alley. And it's a hard, it's a hard, it's a hard, it's hard, it's a hard rain's gonna fall. Oh, who did you meet, my blue-eyed son? And who did you meet, my darling young one? I met a young child beside a dead pony. I met a white man who walked a black dog. I met a young woman, her body was burning. I met a young girl, she gave me a rainbow. I met one man who was wounded in love. I met another man who was wounded in hatred. And it's hard, it's hard, it's hard, it's hard, it's hard. Rains are gonna fall. And what'll you do now, my blue-eyed son? And what'll you do now, my darling young one? I'm going back out for the rain starts a-falling. I walk to the depths of the deepest dark forest, where the people are many and the hands are all empty, where the pellets of poison are flooding their waters, where the home in the valley meets the damp, dirty prison. And the executioner's face is always well hidden. Where the hunger is ugly, where the souls are forgotten. Where black is the color, where none is the number. And I tell it and think it and speak it and breathe it. And reflect from the mountain so all souls can see it. And I stand on the ocean until I start sinking. But I'll know my song well before I start singing. And it's a hard, it's a hard, it's hard, it's hard, it's hard. Rains are gonna fall. It's a fairground song. It's a carnival song. Just a root song. Let's just sort of explain to you a little bit. Oh, it's all up from Florida at the start of the spring. The trucks and the trailers will be winding like a bullet will shoot for the carnival route. We're following them dusty old fairgrounds are calling. From the Michigan mud past the Wisconsin sun, cross that Minnesota border, keep them scrambling through the clear county lakes and the lumberjack lands. We're following them dusty old fairgrounds a-calling. Hit Fargo on the jump and down to Aberdeen. Cross them old black hills, keep them rolling. Through the cow country towns and the sands of old Montana. We're following them fairgrounds a-calling. As the white line on the highway sails under your wheels, I gaze from the trailer window laughing. Oh, our clothes, they was torn, but the colors, they was bright. Following them dusty old fairgrounds a-calling. It's a many a friend that follows the bend. The jugglers, the hustlers, the gamblers. But I spend my time with the fortune-telling kind, following them fairgrounds a-calling. Oh, it's pound down the rails and it's tied down the tents. Get that canvas flag a-flying. Let the caterpillar spin, let the fast wheel wind. Following them fairgrounds a-calling. Well, let's roll into town, straight to the fairgrounds. Just behind the posters that are hanging. And it's fill up every space with a different kind of face. Following them fairgrounds are calling. Get the dancing girls in front, get the gambling show behind. Get that old music box a-banging. Get them kids' faces smiles up and down the Midway aisles. We're following them fairgrounds a-calling. It's a drag it on down by the deadline in the town. Hit the old highway by the morning. And ride yourself blind for the next town on time. Following them fairgrounds a-calling. As the harmonicas wind in the lonesome nighttime, drinking red wine as we're rolling, many turn I turn, many lesson I've learned from following them fairgrounds a-calling. And it's rolled back down to St. Petersburg. Tie down the trailers and camp 'em, and the money that we made will pay for the space.
from following them dusty old fairgrounds a calling.
Want to know about the abolishment of boxing? I would ask Mrs. Benny Kid Perrett and Mrs. Davy Moore before I asked Cassius Clay. Just a personal tendency there. Referee. Don't point your finger at me. Sure, I could have stopped it in the eighth and kept him from his terrible fate. But the crowd would have booed, I'm sure, at not getting their money's worth. It's too bad you had to go, but there was pressure on me too, you know. No, it wasn't me that made him fall. You can't blame me at all. Who killed Davy Moore? Why and what's the reason for? Not us, said the angry crowd, whose screams filled the arena loud. It's too bad he died that night, but we'd just like to see a good fight. We didn't mean for him to meet his death, we'd just like to see some sweat. There ain't nothing wrong in that, it wasn't us that made him fall. You can't blame us at all. Who killed Davy Moore, why, and what's the reason for? Not I, said his manager, puffing on a big cigar. It's hard to say, it's hard to tell. I always thought that he was well. It's too bad for his wife and kids, he's dead. But if he was sick, he should have said, it wasn't me that made him fall. No, you can't blame me at all. Who killed Davy Moore? Why? What's the reason? Not me, says the boxing writer, who pounds the print in his old typewriter, saying boxing ain't to blame, there's just as much danger in a football game. Saying boxing is here to stay, it's just the old American way. No, it wasn't me that made him fall, you can't blame me at all. Who killed Davy Moore, why, and what's the reason for it? Not I, said the man whose fists laid him low in a cloud of mist, who came here from Cuba's door, where boxing ain't allowed no more. I hit him, yes, it's true, but that's what I'm paid to do. Don't say murder, don't say kill, it was destiny, it was God's will. Who killed Davy Moore, why, and what's the reason for? Here's a song, it's based here on an old legend.
O'Reilly stole a stallion, but they caught him and they brought him back, and they laid him down in the jailhouse ground with an iron chain around his neck. O'Reilly's daughter got a message that her father was to hang. She rode by night and came by morning with gold and silver in her hand. When the judge saw Riley's daughter, his old eyes deepened in his head. Saying gold will never free your father, the price, my dear, is you instead. Oh, I'm as good as dead, cried Riley. It's only you that he does crave, and my skin will surely crawl if it touches you at all. Get back on your horse and ride away. Oh, father, you will surely die if I don't take the chance to try to pay the price and not take your advice. For that reason I will have to stay. The gallows shadow shook the evening. In the night, a hound obeyed. In the night, the grounds were groaning. In the night, the price was paid. The next morning, she had awoken, find that the judge had never spoken. She saw that hanging branch bending. She saw her father's body broken. These be seven curses on a judge so cruel. That one doctor cannot save him. That two healers cannot heal him. And that three eyes cannot see him. That four ears cannot hear him. Five walls cannot hide him. That six diggers cannot bury him. And that seven death shall never kill him.
Ooh.
was right, remember now. Have you ever been walking down Highway 51? Have you ever been walking? Highway from night time till the dawn. Well, I know that highway. Yes, I know that highway, I know the back of my hand. I'm from up Wisconsin way, down to love man's land. Well, if I should die before my time should come, or if I should die before my time should come, won't you bury my body? Bury my body, bury my body. I don't know how. Okay, fucking around. Okay. Dirty Peggy. It's a Scottish song, you know. That's the Scottish part. Well, as we march down, as we come down, as we come down to Fenario, well, a captain fell in love with a lady like a dove. The name that she had was Pretty Peggy. What will your mother say? What will your mother say? What will your mother say, Pretty Peggy? Oh, what will your mother say? For I know you're gone away, and you're never, never, never coming back, yo. Well, the lieutenant, he is gone. The lieutenant, he is gone. The lieutenant, he's a gone, Pretty Peggy, oh. The lieutenant, he's a gone. He's long gone. He's fighting the Indians down in Borneo. The corporal, he's gone too. The corporal, he's gone too. He sure is gone, Pretty Peggy, oh. Well, the corporal, he's gone. He's so long gone. He's riding down in Texas with the rodeo. The sergeant, he's dead, Pretty Peggy, oh my dear. The sergeant, he's dead, Pretty Peggy, oh. Oh, the sergeant, he's dead. He's died for a maid, and they buried him someplace down in Louisiana, oh. I'm falling down the stairs, Pretty Peggy, oh my dear. I'm falling down the stairs, Pretty Peggy, oh. I'm falling down the stairs, combing back your yellow hair. You're the prettiest darn girl I've seen, yo. This is called New Orleans Rag. You'll find out why. I'll try to remember all the verses I sing for you. At one time, this was very long. But I don't think it'll be quite that long tonight. I'll see what I can put into it, though.
I was sitting on a stump down in New Orleans. I was feeling kind of low down, dirty and mean. Along come a fella, and he didn't even ask. Says I know of a woman who can fix you up fast. Well, I didn't think twice. I just said like I should, let you go find this lady who can do me some good. We walked across a rampart on a sailing spree, and we come to a door called 103. I was just about ready to give my little knock when out come a fella who couldn't even walk. He's a linking and a slinking, couldn't stand on his feet, and he moaned and he groaned and he shuffled down the street. Well, out of the door there come another man. He couldn't even talk and he couldn't even stand. He moaned and he groaned and he shuffled his feet and he slid sliding backwards down Ramford Street. Well, I peeked through the keyhole and coming down the hall was a long-legged man who could hardly crawl. He had a terrible mean look in his eye like he just fought a bear and he was ready to die. Well, somebody else with his hair all messed fell out of the window and he failed the test. Well, he slid and he slunk in broken French and he looked like he'd been through a monkey ranch. Well, by this time I wasn't scared to knock, I wasn't scared to move, I was in a state of shock. I hummed a little tune and I shuffled my feet and I started walking backwards down the Ramford Street. Well, I got to the corner, I tried my best to smile, I turned around the corner and I run a bloody mile. Man, I wasn't running for to meet my wife, I was just running for to save my life. Well, I was coughing in my ears and wheezing in my chest, I must have run a mile in a minute or less. I tripped on a log and I flumped on a stump. I caught a fast freight train with a one-arm jump. So if you're traveling down Louisiana way and you're feeling kind of lonesome and you need a place to stay, man, you're better off in your misery than to tackle that lady at 103.
Those things happen, you know. There's that. You gotta be pretty good to sing this song here. I don't know if I can sing it really. But I wrote it, so. Well, it ain't no use to sit and wonder why, babe, if and you don't know by now. And it ain't no use to sit and wonder why, babe, it don't matter anyhow. When your rooster crows at the break of dawn, look out your window and I'll be gone. You're the reason I'm traveling on, but don't think twice, it's alright. And it ain't no use in turning on your light, babe, the light I never knowed. And it ain't no use in turning on your light, babe, I'm on the dark side of the road. But still I wish there's something you would do or say to try and make me change my mind and stay. But we never did too much talking anyway, so don't think twice, it's all right. And it ain't no use in calling out my name, girl, like you never did before. And it ain't no use in calling out my name, girl. I can't hear you anymore. I was thinking and wondering, hey, walking down the road. I once loved a woman, hey, child, I'm a toll. I give her my heart, but she wanted my soul. But don't think twice, it's all right. So I'm walking down that long, lonesome road, babe. Where I'm bound, I can't tell. Goodbye is too good a word, gal. So I'll just say fairly well. I ain't a saint, treated me unkind. You could have done better, but I don't mind. You just kind of wasted my precious time. But don't think twice, it's all right. Super patriotic people at sea, that hating and fearing is my only way. That this here country has got to be. You're thinking of yourselves, you ain't thinking of me. You're not thinking of any George Washington. You're not thinking of any Thomas Jefferson. But you say that you are, and you lie and mislead. You use their names for your aims, for your selfish greed. Don't speak to me of your patriotism when you throw the southern black boy in prison. And you say the only good niggers are the ones that have died. Don't think I'll ever stand on your side. Though you make it so hard for me to love, my face will never feel the slap of your glove. My cards will never buy, my hands will never buy the cards that you play. My feet will never walk down the road that you lay. Get out in the open, stop standing afar. Let the whole world see what a hypocrite you are. I ain't joking and it ain't no gag. You've been hiding too long behind the American flag. This one's called With God on Your Side. Oh, my name, it means nothing. My age, it means less. The country I come from is called the Midwest. I was brought up there and taught there the laws to abide. And the land that I live in has God on its side. All the history books tell it, they tell it so well. The cavalry's charged, the Indians fell. The cavalry's charged, the Indians died. Ah, the country was young with God on its side. Ah, the Spanish-American War had its day. And the Civil War too was soon laid away. And the names of the heroes I was made to memorize. With guns in their hands and God on their side. Oh, the First World War, boys, it came and it went. A reason for fighting I never did get. But I learned to accept it with pride. For you don't count the dead when God's on your side. When the Second World War came to an end, we forgave the Germans, and we were friends. Though they killed 6 million in the ovens they fried, the Germans now too have God on their side. I've learned to hate Russians all through my whole life. If another war starts, it's them we must fight. To hate them and fear them, to run and to hide. And accept it all bravely, with God on my side. But now we got weapons of the chemical dust. If fire them we're forced to, then fire them we must. One push of the button and it shot the world wide. And you never ask questions when God's on your side. In a many dark hour, I've been thinking about this. That Jesus Christ was betrayed by a kiss. But I can't think for you
you'll have to decide whether Judas Iscariot had God on his side. So now as I'm leaving, I'm weary as hell. The confusion I'm feeling ain't no tongue can tell. The words fill my head and fall to the floor. That if God's on our side, he'll stop the next war.
I'm sorry, I only got a few more, at least this is, as far as I know, it's last. I got to sing something to tell you something. I don't mind the Ten Commandments. I believe in the Ten Commandments. The first one, I'm the Lord thy God, is a great commandment if it's not said by the wrong people. You know? So it's called Masters of War. Come, you masters of war, you that build the big guns, you that build the death planes, you that build all the bombs, you that hide behind walls, you that hide behind discs, I just want you to know I can see through your mask. You that never done nothing but build to destroy. You play with my world like it's your little toy. You put a gun in my hand and you hide from my eyes. And you turn and run farther when the fast bullets fly. Like Judas of old, you lie and deceive. Where a war can be won, you want me to believe. But I see through your eyes, and I see through your brain, like I see through the water that runs down my drain. You fasten all the triggers for the others to fire. Then you sit back and watch when the death count gets higher. You hide in your mansion while the young people's blood flows out of their bodies and is buried in the mud. You've thrown the worst fear can ever be hurled. Fear to bring children into the world. Oh, threatening my baby, unborn and unnamed. You ain't worth the blood that runs in your veins. How much do I know to talk out of turn? You might say that I'm young, you might say I'm unlearned, but there's one thing I know, though I'm younger than you, that even Jesus would never forgive what you do. Let me ask you one question. Is your money that good? Will it buy you forgiveness? Do you think that it could? I think you will find, when your death takes its toll, all the money you made will never buy back your soul. And I hope that you die, and your death will come soon. I'll follow your casket by the pale afternoon, and I'll watch while you're lowered down to your deathbed, and I'll stand over your grave till I'm sure that you're dead.
I have a poem. It's not a poem here, but it's something. It's the first concert I've played alone, really, in New York. And there's a fella out in Brooklyn State Hospital. His name is Woody Guthrie. And Woody is really sort of more than a folk singer. He's really something else, more than a folk singer. And there's this book coming out, and they asked me to write something about Woody. Sort of like, what does Woody Guthrie mean to you in 25 words? And I couldn't do it. I wrote out 5 pages, and I have it here. It's a, have it here by accident, actually. but I'd like to say this out loud. So. If you can sort of roll along with this thing here. This is called Last Thoughts on Woody Guthrie. When your head gets twisted and your mind grows numb, when you think you're too old, too young, too smart, or too dumb, when you're lagging behind and losing your pace in a slow motion crawl or life's busy race, no matter what you're doing, if you start giving up, if the wine don't come to the top of your cup, if the wind got you sideways with one hand holding on and the other starts slipping and the feeling is gone, and your train engine fire needs a new spark to catch it, and the wood's easy finding, but you're lazy to fetch it. And your sidewalk starts curling, and the street gets too long, and you start walking backwards, so you know that it's wrong, and lonesome comes up as down goes the day, and tomorrow's morning seems so far away, and you feel the reins from your pony are slipping, and your rope is a sliding because your hands are dripping, and your sun-desert and evergreen valleys turn to broken-down slums and trash can alleys. And your sky cries water, and your drain pipes are pouring, and the lightning's a-flashing, and the thunder's a-crashing, and the windows are rattling and breaking, and the rooftops are shaking, and your whole world's a-slamming and banging, and your minutes of sun turn to hours of storm, and to yourself you sometimes say, I never knew it was going to be this way, why didn't they tell me the day I was born? And you start getting chills, and you're jumping from sweat, and you're looking for something you ain't quite found yet, and you're knee-deep in dark water with your hands in the air, and the whole world's watching with a window peak stare, and your good gal leaves, and she's long gone a-flying, and your heart feels sick like fish when they're frying. And your jackhammer falls from your hands to your feet, but you need it badly and it lays on the street. And your bell's banging loudly, but you can't hear its beat. And you think your ears might have been hurt, or your eyes have turned filthy from the sight-binding dirt. And you figured you failed in yesterday's rush, and you were faked out and fooled while facing a four flush, and all the time you're holding three queens. It's making you mad, it's making you mean, like in the middle of Life magazine, bouncing around a pinball machine. And there's something on your mind that you want to be saying, that somebody someplace ought to be hearing. But it's trapped on your tongue, sealed in your head, and it bothers you badly when you're laying in bed. And no matter how you try, you just can't say it, and you're scared to your soul, you just might forget it. And your eyes get soaky from the tears in your head, and your pillows of feathers turn to blankets of lead, and the lion's mouth opens, and you're staring at his teeth, and his jaws start closing with you underneath, and you're flat on your belly with your hands tied behind, and you wish you'd never taken that last detour sign. You say to yourself, just what am I doing? On this road I'm walking, on this trail I'm turning, on this curve I'm hanging, on this pathway I'm strolling, in the space I'm taking, in this air I'm inhaling. Am I mixed up too much? Am I mixed up too hard? Why am I walking? Where am I running? What am I saying? What am I knowing on this guitar I'm playing? On this banjo I'm feeling? On this mandolin I'm strumming? In a song I'm singing? In a tune I'm humming? In the words that I'm thinking? In the words I'm writing? In this ocean of hours I'm all the time drinking? Who am I helping? What am I breaking? What am I giving? What am I taking? But you try with your whole soul best never to think these thoughts, and never to let them kind of thoughts gain ground or make your heart pound. But then again, you know when they're around, just waiting for a chance to slip and drop down. Cause sometimes you hear them in the nighttime come creeping, and you fear they might catch you sleeping, and you jump from your bed from the last chapter of dreaming, and you can't remember for the best of your thinking if that was you in a dream that was screaming. And you know that's something special you're needing. You know there's no drug that'll do for the healing, and no liquor in the land to stop your brain from bleeding. You need something special. You need something special, all right. You need a fast-flying train on a tornado track to shoot you someplace and shoot you back. You need a cyclone wind on a steam engine howler that's been banging and booming and blowing forever, that knows your troubles 100 times over. You need a greyhound bus that don't bar no race, that won't laugh at your looks, your voice, or your face, and buying a number of bets in the book will be rolling long after the bubblegum craze. You need something to open up a new door to show you something you've seen before but overlooked 100 times or more. You need something to open your eyes. You need something to make it known that it's you and no one else that owns that spot that you're standing, that space that you're sitting, that the world ain't got you beat. It ain't got you licked, it can't get you crazy, no matter how many times you might get kicked. You need something special, all right. You need something special to give you hope. But hope's just a word that maybe you said, maybe you heard on some windy corner around a wide-angle curve. But that's what you need, man, and you need it bad. And your trouble is you know it too good, because you look and you start getting the chills, because you can't find it on a dollar bill. And it ain't on Macy's windowsill. And it ain't on real rich kid's roadmap, and it ain't made in no fat kid's fraternity house, and it ain't made in no Hollywood wheat germ, and it ain't on that dim-lit stage with that half-wit comedian on it, ranting and raving and taking your money, and you think it's funny. Now you can't find it neither in no nightclub, no yacht club, and it ain't in the seats of a supper club, and sure as hell you're bound to tell, no matter how hard you rub, you just ain't gonna find it on your ticket stub. No, it ain't in the rumors people are telling you, and it ain't in the pimple lotion people are selling you, and it ain't in the cardboard box house or down any movie star's blouse, and you can't find it on the golf course. And Uncle Remus can't tell you, and neither can Santa Claus. And ain't in the cream puff hairdo or cotton candy clothes. Ain't in the dime store dummies and bubblegum goons. And ain't in the marshmallow noises of the chocolate cake voices that come knocking and tapping and Christmas rapping, saying, ain't I pretty and ain't I cute? Look at my skin. Look at my skin shine. Look at my skin glow. Look at my skin laugh. Look at my skin cry, when you can't even sense it's got any insides, these people so pretty in their ribbons and bows. Now you'll not now or no other day find it on the doorsteps made of paper mache, and inside with the people made of molasses that every other day buy a new pair of sunglasses. And ain't in the 50-star generals and flipped out phonies who turn you in for a tenth of a penny, who breathe and burp and bend and crack, and before you can count from 1 to 10, do it all over again, but this time behind your back, my friend. The ones that wheel and deal and whirl and twirl and play games with each other in the sandbox world. You can't find it either in the no-talent fools that run around gallant and make all the rules for the ones that got talent. And ain't the ones that ain't got any talent but think they do and think they're fooling you. The ones that jump on the wagon just for a while because they know it's in style, to get the kicks, get out of it quick, and make all kinds of money and chicks. And you yell to yourself and you throw down your hat saying, Christ, do I got to be like that? Ain't there no one here that knows where I'm at? Ain't there no one here that knows how I feel? Good God Almighty, that stuff ain't real. No, but that ain't your game. It ain't your race. You can't hear your name. You can't see your face. You got to look some other place. And where do you look for this hope that you're seeking? Where do you look for this lamp that's burning? Where do you look for this oil well gushing? Where do you look for this candle that's glowing? Where do you look for this hope that you know is there and out there somewhere? And your feet can only walk down 2 kinds of roads. Your eyes can only look through 2 kinds of windows. Your nose can only smell 2 kinds of hallways. You can touch and twist and turn 2 kinds of doorknobs. You can either go to the church of your choice or you go to Brooklyn State Hospital. You find God in the church of your choice. You find Woody Guthrie in Brooklyn State Hospital. No, it's only my opinion. I may be right or wrong. You find them both in Grand Canyon, sundown.